First on Five, Super Tuesday just hours away, and candidates are making their last push to get the vote out. It is a repeat performance for candidates in Alabama's District 1 congressional race. News 5's Debbie Williams is live in Foley, and Debbie, we've been here before.
Yes, we have. It seems like every time this seat is up for grabs, these two are going at it. Challenger Dean Young thinks the third time will be the charm for him, while Congressman Bradley Byrne, the incumbent, is confident he will be going back to Washington.
Hey, folks, how are y'all?
With time ticking away,
doing a good job.
Two Republican congressional candidates face off again. Third time going to be the charm for you and Bradley?
We'll see.
Challenger Dean Young is using social media and phone calls to get voters motivated.
People are on phones, people are emailing, Facebooking, and making sure that our voters get out to vote tomorrow, because that's what's going to make the difference.
So proud of you.
Thank you, thank you.
Bradley Byrne is doing it the old-fashioned way.
Such positive feedback from the voters everywhere we go. We've been taking advantage of the last several days to get out and just see people one-on-one, shake hands, say hello.
And even as the campaign winds down, neither candidate is pulling any punches.
He would be the least effective member of the U.S. House of Representatives. He would find virtually no one that would want to work with him.
Do we want the same old, or are we going to stop this foolishness and get our country safe again?
Both candidates believe that a huge turnout will be key in their victories. Polls open tomorrow at 7 o'clock. Live on the Baldwin County Beat in Foley, Debbie Williams, News 5.
Thanks, Debbie. Jeff Sessions is not on the ballot, but he's making more headlines right now than any candidate who is. And that's because yesterday at a rally in Birmingham, Sessions became the first U.S. senator to endorse Donald Trump for president. Many were not shocked since Sessions appeared on stage with Trump in Mobile last August. And the billionaire businessman has been carrying Sessions' fight against immigration and for foreign trade changes. Today on Talk Radio in Birmingham, Sessions says it's clear that Trump will be his party's nominee.
It does appear that he's bringing into the party, the Republican Party, a whole new group of people. And really, that's what I've been arguing for a long time.
But many are surprised by the endorsement, saying beyond immigration, Trump and Sessions have nothing in common. We'll have more on that tonight at 6 o'clock.